Black holes are the most terrifying things in existence. Silent monsters that warp time and shatter physics. They don't just swallow stars and planets, they erase information itself. Over trillions of years, they'll consume everything we know, and then they'll vanish too. On today's episode of the Infographics Show, we're explaining how a black hole will delete our entire universe. When a star at least 20 times more massive than our sun runs out of fuel, it faces a crisis. For millions of years, the star has been in perfect balance, nuclear fusion pushing outward from the core, gravity pulling inward. But once that fuel is gone, that balance collapses. Without fusion to hold it up, gravity wins. The star's core collapses in less than a second, compressing matter so dense that a teaspoon would weigh as much as Mount Everest. But the collapse doesn't stop there, or ever, really. The matter keeps compressing until it becomes a singularity, a point of infinite density, where physics breaks down completely. This creates a gravitational field so intense, it warps space-time itself. Imagine space-time as a stretched rubber sheet. A bowling ball makes a dip in the sheet. A black hole? Well, that punches a hole straight through it. The event horizon is the point of no return, the boundary where escape velocity exceeds the speed of light. Cross that line and you are not just doomed, you're actually deleted, at least from the universe's perspective. If Earth somehow collapsed into a black hole, that event horizon would be less than an inch across. An entire planet's worth of matter compressed into a sphere smaller than a marble. And here is the most unsettling part. Black holes are completely invisible. They are the ultimate stealth predators. We can only detect them by watching what they do to everything around them. Stars orbiting invisible partners, matter heating to millions of degrees before vanishing forever into the void. Black holes basically come in three versions, each one more terrifying than the last. Stellar mass black holes are your run-of-the-mill void destroyers. They're the most common type, but that doesn't make them any less terrifying. Born from the violent death of massive stars, they typically weigh in at 5 to 50 times the mass of our sun. They're like soul-sucking landmines scattered throughout every galaxy. Our Milky Way alone contains an estimated 100 million of these invisible killers drifting silently through space. The closest one we know about is called V616 Monocerotis. It sits just 3,000 light-years away. In cosmic terms, that's practically next door. It's currently feeding on a companion star, slowly stripping away its partner's atmosphere and essence in a process that'll take millions of years. The victim star has no escape. It's being eaten alive in slow motion. And then there's supermassive black holes. These are the real monsters of the universe. They weigh anywhere from millions to billions of times more than our sun. Every major galaxy has one lurking at its center, including our own. Sagittarius A star sits at the heart of our Milky Way, about 26,000 light-years from Earth. It weighs 4 million times more than our sun and could swallow our entire solar system. Right now, it's relatively quiet, just occasionally snacking on gas clouds and a star that wanders too close. Venture further out into space and you would run into primordial black holes, essentially the wild cards of the black hole hierarchy. These theoretical objects could range from microscopic to mountain-sized, formed in the chaotic early moments after the Big Bang. Scientists are not sure they actually exist, but if they do, they could be lurking everywhere, which is more than a little unsettling. Some might be smaller than atoms, but weigh as much as asteroids. Others could be drifting through our solar system right now, completely invisible, and instantly lethal to anything that strays too close. What makes black holes so terrifying is that they almost never lose weight. Every piece of matter that falls in just makes them bigger and more dangerous. And worst of all, they are incredibly patient. When you get close to a black hole, time doesn't just slow down, it gets tortured. If you watched an object approaching a black hole's event horizon, you would see it slow down, becoming redder, dimmer, and more distorted. From your perspective, it would appear to freeze at the edge, its final moment stretched across eternity. You would literally watch it fade away over billions of years, never quite crossing the line. But in reality, the object fell through the event horizon in normal time, completely unaware that outside the universe sees them as frozen. Spaghettification might sound like a made-up word, but it is real. As an object falls into a black hole, the gravitational pull on its lower half becomes much stronger than on the upper half. That difference stretches it like cosmic taffy, pulling it into a thin stream of atoms spiraling helplessly toward the singularity. For a stellar mass black hole, this happens well before you reach the event horizon. You would be spaghettified while still technically outside of the black hole itself. For supermassive black holes, the event horizon is so large that you might cross it while still intact, only to be torn apart closer to the center. Either way, you don't stay you for very long. Ironically, getting sucked in is where black holes seem to break physics in the most fundamental way possible. Quantum mechanics has one absolute rule: information cannot be created nor destroyed. The quantum state of every particle, every interaction, every moment of history must be preserved somehow, somewhere. But black holes seem to violate this rule completely. When something falls into a black hole, all information about it appears to be erased forever. This creates what physicists call the information paradox. Either quantum mechanics is wrong, or our understanding of black holes is incomplete, or reality itself works in ways we can't comprehend. And all three are more than plausible. Some theorists think that information is somehow encoded in the Hawking radiation that black holes emit. This is residual thermal energy named after the famous first proponent of the information paradox, Stephen Hawking. Others suggest it's written on the black hole's surface-particle interactions, like a deep space hard drive. But some think space-time itself might be an illusion, and information exists in some higher dimensional realm that we can't access. But what if none of these solutions work? What if black holes really do destroy information? Then everything that has ever happened, every human life, every thought, every moment, could theoretically be permanently erased. And not just from existence, but from the possibility of ever having existed. In 1974, Stephen Hawking made a discovery that would fundamentally change our understanding of black holes. Before this, black holes were thought to trap everything that entered them, with no way for anything to escape. Then Hawking applied quantum mechanics to the curved space-time around black holes and discovered something extraordinary. These supposedly eternal monsters are actually dying, one particle at a time. Hawking's equation revealed something counterintuitive and deeply unsettling. Smaller black holes are actually hotter than larger ones, and hot objects evaporate faster than cool ones. A black hole with the mass of our sun has a temperature of about 60 billionths of a degree above absolute zero. That is colder than the microwave background radiation left over from the Big Bang. These black holes are so cold they are actually gaining mass by absorbing background radiation faster than they lose it through Hawking evaporation. But shrink that black hole down to the mass of a mountain, and then suddenly it's as hot as our sun's surface. That's the principle of Hawking radiation in action. Make it the mass of a car, and it becomes hot enough to vaporize any material we know of. A black hole with the mass of a paperclip would have a temperature of billions of degrees. This creates a devastating feedback loop. As black holes evaporate and lose mass, they get hotter. And as they get hotter, they evaporate faster. And as they evaporate faster, they get smaller and hotter still. The final moments of a black hole's death are explosive, a tiny remnant that would detonate with the energy of millions of hydrogen bombs. Right now, the largest black holes in the universe are still growing because they're colder than their surroundings. The cosmic microwave background that fills all space has a temperature of about 2.7 Kelvin above absolute zero, or negative 454 degrees Fahrenheit. A supermassive black hole has a temperature millions of times lower. This means that black holes won't start shrinking until the universe cools so completely that the cosmic background temperature drops below their own. For the largest ones, that won't happen until the universe is thousands or even millions of times older than it is today. The universe is like a massive city, where black holes are the only immortal residents. Everyone else ages, dies, and gets replaced. But the black holes, they just keep getting bigger and more powerful. In the early days, black holes grow slowly and are vastly outnumbered. The Milky Way forms only a few new stars each year. Meanwhile, its central black hole gains roughly the mass of Earth once every 1,000 years. For now, the stars are winning. Over the next billion years, the pace picks up. Galaxy collisions become more common as cosmic expansion slows the most distant objects, while the nearby galaxy clusters continue their gravitational dance. When galaxies merge, their central supermassive black holes eventually spiral into each other, creating even more monstrous entities. The Milky Way's scheduled collision with Andromeda in 4.5 billion years will be just the beginning. 100 trillion years from now is when things will start to get interesting. Star formation grinds to a halt as the galaxies drift apart and the universe's hydrogen supply runs low. No new stars means no new sources of light, heat, or heavy elements. The universe begins to slide into permanent darkness. A quadrillion years from now is when the last red dwarf stars, the universe's most efficient fusion reactors, finally burn out after lifespans that dwarf the current age of the cosmos. Now we're left with stellar corpses, white dwarfs cooling like cosmic embers, neutron stars spinning in the dark, and black holes that have been patient all this time. The real feeding frenzy happens on smaller scales. Every dead star becomes potential black hole food. White dwarfs, those Earth-sized stellar corpses that could shine dimly for trillions of years, eventually spiral into their dark neighbors. Neutron stars, matter so dense that a matchbox-sized piece would weigh about 3 billion tons, get swallowed whole. Planets don't escape either. Those that survive wander through space until gravitational interactions eventually deliver them to hungry black holes. Jupiter, Earth, every asteroid, and comet are all destined for the same fate. Then comes the final moment, a brilliant terminal flash of gamma rays and particles, releasing as much energy in an instant as our sun produces over its entire lifetime, the universe's last firework. But by then, there will be no one left to witness the show. This slow-motion apocalypse would take longer to complete than the current age of the universe, multiplied by itself a trillion times over. So for now, black holes are outnumbered. They are the minority in a universe dominated by normal matter, stars, planets, gas clouds, and all the everyday stuff that makes up galaxies. But they are playing the ultimate long game. Let's now fast forward to 10 octillion years and the black hole era. The universe has become unrecognizably alien. There are no stars twinkling in the sky because there is no sky, and there are no stars. No planets orbit, no chemistry occurs, no complex structures can form. The temperature hovers just above absolute zero. The only remaining activity is the slow, silent merging of black holes, a cosmic dance unfolding across distances so vast that light would take longer to cross them than the entire age of our universe. Just as there is a hierarchy of black holes, there would be a hierarchy of survivors. The smallest black holes, those with just a few solar masses, would be the first to disappear, going out in spectacular bursts of energy. The stellar mass black holes would follow over timescales that make the current age of the universe seem like a fleeting moment. But the supermassive black holes are in it for the long haul. A black hole with a billion solar masses would take 10 octadecillion years to completely evaporate. The largest theoretical black holes could survive for 10 unquinquagintillion years. Now that's a time span so vast that you could fit the entire age of our universe inside it a Google times over. That's a 1 followed by 100 zeros. It is the loneliest possible existence. In perfect darkness, the temperature of empty space is so close to absolute zero that the difference is meaningless. No chemistry is possible, no complex structures can form. As cosmic expansion continues, even these final black holes become increasingly isolated. The universe grows even larger and colder, stretching space itself until each black hole sits alone in its own expanding bubble of emptiness. The cruel mathematics of expansion mean that eventually black holes become so far apart, they can no longer interact gravitationally. Each black hole becomes a universe unto itself, the only source of gravitational disturbance in its local region of space-time. The concept of nearby becomes meaningless. Your nearest neighbor is so far away that even if you could somehow communicate at the speed of light, a simple hello would take longer to reach them than our universe has existed. There is one more terrifying future, albeit an abstract one, that we should also explore. In 2023, researchers began exploring whether Hawking radiation might not be limited to black holes. Their calculations suggest that gravity itself might cause all massive objects to eventually evaporate through quantum effects. This means that even after the last black holes evaporate, even after the universe becomes nothing but a cold, dark expanse populated by elementary particles, the deletion process might continue. Anything with mass, including the fundamental particles themselves, might emit their own form of Hawking-like radiation and slowly fade away. The research is still preliminary, but the implications are staggering. Every electron, every photon, every neutrino that survives the black hole era might itself be temporary, doomed to evaporate over timescales that make black hole lifetimes look brief. Physicists have long predicted that the universe would end in heat death, a state of maximum entropy where all the energy is evenly distributed and no work can be done. What that basically becomes is a type of cosmic equilibrium where nothing interesting can ever happen again. But the new theoretical work suggests something even more final than heat death. After all massive particles evaporate and all energy gradients disappear, the universe might continue its relentless march toward absolute nothingness. Even the tiny amount of energy represented by the cosmic microwave background might eventually dissipate through processes we don't yet understand. The universe's final temperature would approach absolute zero, not just practically, but theoretically. In that state, even the quantum vacuum energy that drives virtual particle creation might be exhausted. If black holes truly destroy information, then consciousness, memory, and meaning are all temporary illusions. The universe in this hypothetical becomes a place where everything not only dies but is forgotten. Before existential dread sets in, these processes unfold on timelines so vast that they make the concept of forever seem like the blink of an eye. In about 6 billion years, our sun will expand into a red giant, rendering Earth uninhabitable. It'll be gone long before black holes pose any real threat to our solar system. Meanwhile, the Milky Way is on a slow-motion collision course with the Andromeda Galaxy, set to merge in 4.5 billion years. Surprisingly, most star systems, including ours, will remain undisturbed. But by the time black holes begin to dominate the cosmos, humanity, if we even still exist, will have changed so much that we might not even be able to recognize ourselves. We're talking about a future so distant that stars will have formed, burned out, and vanished, trillions of times over. In the end, black holes won't just erase matter, they will erase meaning. If black holes are the ultimate cosmic destroyers, then what happens when the universe gives us the opposite? Find out in What is a White Hole, opposite of Black Hole? Or click this video instead.